Okay, today we are going to see about the fourth unit, which is the fourth unit, synchronous generator or alternator. Okay, this is the unit of our fourth unit, synchronous generator or alternator. What is mean by synchronous generator? What is mean by generator, which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy? Already in the machines one we have seen DC generator. Okay, DC generator already with mechanical energy. This is AC generator, that's all. This is DC generator. Here we are going to see about AC generator. Where we are using this AC generators? We are using this AC generators in power stations. Power station means thermal power stations, hydro power station, nuclear power station, to generate bulk power, because here everywhere we are using electrical energy, we are consuming electric energy. Where it is generated? It is generated in the power stations, hydro power station. Bulk power will be produced, not small power will be produced. Even if we are having small generators in our university, generator 1 kVA or 75 kVA or 750 kVA, like that power generators we are having, that are small generators. Okay, but a bulk generators will be used, where it will be used means it is used in the power plants. So it is called synchronous generator or alternator. What is mean by synchronous? Because synchronous means it will run only at synchronous speed, any other speed it won't run. So what is synchronous speed? We know that ns equal to 120 f by p, only it will run at this synchronous speed. In India the frequency will be 50 hertz, so it will only run at synchronous speed. Okay, like this, the poles will be 4-pole machine, means this will run at how much speed it will run? It will run always run at 1500 rpm. It won't run at any other RPM. So that is called, it is synchronous generator. Other name is called AC generator. So it is called as alternator. AC generator, alternator. Okay, whether we are generating single phase or three phase, means three phase only we are generating, because if you use only one winding in the armature, we will generate single phase. If you use three windings, we will get three phase. So why should we go for single phase? Because the prime mover is going to run and we are going to generate. Okay. So how the prime mover is running, maybe how we are getting mechanical energy? Simply I am taking a which thing, hydro power plant. What will happen? There will be turbine will be there. The turbine will be like this thing. I am correct? It will be like this thing. Okay, water will hit the turbine in which a very high velocity. So automatically what will happen? This turbine will rotate. This turbine will directly couple with this synchronous generator. Okay, this is similar generator, it will generate electrical energy. Okay, any machine, if you go for any machine, for example DC generator, so far we have seen DC generator, DC motor, or what are the other thing, induction motor, everywhere there are two primary components are there. One is stator, other one is rotor. Which will be stator? Magnet, that is called field, will be stator, and which will be rotor? Armature will be rotor. This is the thing. So far we have seen. So what are the main two components? One will be armature, another will be field. What is the purpose of field? It will produce flux. For example, I will take simple DC generator. Take the simple generator, North Pole and South Pole. This is called field. F. This is called, what is the purpose of field? It will produce flux. This will produce flux. Armature will be placed here. Armature is made up of copper windings. Okay, this turbine will couple here, this will rotate. So armature is rotor, this is stator. This is normally we are having in DC generators, DC motor, in induction motor also. So it is called stator and this is called rotor. But in this synchronous generator or alternator, it is reversed. So which is stator? This armature is stator and this is rotor. Which is rotor? Field is rotor. Why? That's the thing we have to see. That's the very, very thing. So why we are going for the reverse things? See, so far we have seen generator, we need two components. We are having two components. One component is armature, other one is field. Okay. But here field is rotating, armature is stationary. Why? So this is the main thing, advantage of stationary armature or advantage of rotating magnet or rotating field. I can say as rotating field. What is the advantage of this thing? Advantage of stationary armature or advantage of rotating field? This is an important 4-mark question. Why we are going for rotating field or why we are going for stationary armature? Okay, what is armature is going to produce? It is going to produce electrical energy. Okay, what is the field we are going to give? DC supply. It's an electromagnet. Okay, suppose if you take it as an alternator. Okay, before that going that one alternate of three phase alternator only. In a three phase alternator, either we can connect the three phase in star connected or delta connected. Normally we will go for star connected. I will explain this later why we are going for star connected. Armature. Armature is star connected. This armature is made up of star. Okay, this is armature. This is stationary stator. Okay, this is okay. Like this thing. This is given to long line, it will transmit and it will given to load. Three phase load or single phase load. It is given to load. Okay, this is given to load. This is the winding. This winding is called R winding. This is Y winding and this is B winding and this is neutral point. This thing. Here it will be star connected. This is stationary. Which is rotor? This here field coil. Field coil here it is rotor. This is FFF, that is North Pole and South Pole. This is given with DC supply. DC supply. This is given with DC supply. Okay. What is the main advantage of having stationary armature? Means, see, this armature will produce very high current. For example, normally practically it will have more than 1000 amps current it will produce. Okay, more than 1000 amps current it will produce. So, this current will be very, very high, 1000 amps. Okay, this how much current we have to give to convert them INPs into electromagnets? Maximum very less amount current. Maximum it will be 5 amps to 10 amps only. Maximum we are going to give, only less than 10 amps we are going to give. So, suppose this is rotating. So, I cannot tap the energy. I have to have slip rings and brushes because if this is rotating, I cannot directly tap. If it is rotating, I should have a slip ring and brushes to tap the energy. So, if for a heavy high current, in the brushes, there will be sparking will be very high. That's the main thing. Okay. Suppose this is rotating. What having a same things as be, if this is rotating, I need which thing? Because this is battery stationary, this is rotating, so connect this thing. I have to connect via slip rings only because this is stationary battery, this is rotating one, so I need slip rings and brushes to connect in stationary part into or rotating part. So here how much only we are giving 5 amps, so the size of the brushes, slip rings and brushes will be also small, the sparking also very small. So that's the main thing we are going for stationary armature. If we go for stationary armature with the slip rings we are using, it will be very, very small in size. Here we will use a slip rings, here we will use a slip ring, so that this is stationary, this is rotating part. Not only slip rings, with slip rings I have to connect the brushes. Here the slip ring brushes size will be very small, so it can withstand only 5 amps or 10 amps. But here if we go for rotating armature, I had to go for very high slip rings and brushes. To avoid this thing, we are going for rotating field. That's the main thing. Then second thing is that suppose here I have to go for how many slip rings and brush assembly? 3 I had to go, but here I need only 2. That's another advantage. These are the major 2 advantages. Remaining all are cooling purposes. That will be easy cooling purposes or stationary armature, means we can easily cool the armature. Like this, many advantages, air gap we can use, all those things. The main thing is that the slip rings and brush assembly, because here if I go for slip ring assembly, I have to go for a very high thing. So this is the main thing, we are going for stationary armature. Okay, this is the thing. Second, okay. Next, what is the thing we are going to see about means star. Why we are going for star connected? Why we are not going for a neutral delta connected armature, delta connected? Because delta connected. Okay, before that thing, I have to explain. This armature will be connected with this. Which thing? This is connected with this, our prime mover. Prime mover means that is the thing already we have seen, which is prime mover. This what is called turbine is a prime mover. Turbine will coupled with this thing, so this will rotate. When this rotate, this is subject to change in flux. Whenever change in flux, armature is subject to change in flux, EMF will be induced here. Okay, that's a working principle of an alternator. These are already we have seen the DC generator itself. Okay, E equal to d phi by dt, all those things. Okay, why we are going for star connected? why we are going for star connected means, before that, why we are having three wires, why we cannot generate single phase? Yes, I cannot generate single phase if I am having only one winding. The single phase supply is going to generate, but why we have to waste the energy? Single, since we already what the thing is, the prime mover is running. If you use single winding, I will get single phase. If I use three winding, I will get three phase. Why should we waste the energy? So I am using three windings. So how these windings are connected? Delta or star? Star. Why we are not going for delta? The main advantage of star connected is, here I can perfectly, I can neutral, the neutral point is grounded, neutral point I can ground is, that is one advantage. The another advantage is that whatever amount of voltage generated here, here the line voltage, this is called phase voltage, this will be in the inside this thing, this is called, this voltage is called phase voltage, this voltage is called line voltage, this voltage. So whatever voltage generated here, this voltage, whatever voltage generated here, this voltage is called phase voltage, this voltage is called line voltage. So I will get root 3 times of the phase voltage I will get. But in delta connected, if you go, both will be same. So that only we are, main advantage of star connected means, the phase voltage will be, the line voltage will be root 3 times of our phase voltage. But current will be same. The current being star connected, current here, if I armature current, this is load current, both will be same in case of star connected. But advantage means, here I am getting only how much phase voltage I am getting? Here V phase, here I will get root 3 times of V phase. So that's only we are going for, which connection? Star connected alternator.